Good morning, Seattle.
Our flight from Chicago landed late last night, and now we are staying with our friends in Seattle, Steve and Nancy. We only have one day to explore all of Seattle, and then we have to head out east to Montana. So, we're gonna make the most of it.
Really?
We stayed with...
That's not what you're supposed to do, but they're changing their mind about all
this. Yeah, I know, right.
We stayed with the same people in Portland, and I was hoping they would get rid of the giant spiders, but... Fortunately, they brought them with them to Seattle. That's all right, I'm not that scared. All right, time to explore Seattle.
Yep. I don't practice Santeria. I ain't got no Christmas.
Our first stop in Seattle is going to be Gasworks Park. So it's this former gasification plant that has now been converted into a public park. You can walk through the ruins, it's kind of cool. Let's check it out. You can walk through the old machinery. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. You have something that's abandoned, open it to the public. There's Seattle. Can you tell? That is some major haze. Check out the houseboats. Would you guys live on one of those?
I would.
Our next stop is going to be one of the most famous real estate holdouts in the United States. It was once owned by Edith Macefield, and it's this one-story house. And as Seattle grew, the government offered her up to $1 million just to use her property to build like a taller building, but she kept on refusing. So now it's famous for being a real estate holdout.
So here's all the urbanized parts of Seattle. And right here is the house that she hung on to. She refused to give up.
Alright, so look at this sculpture. The funny thing is, covered up by the water there is a statue of a naked boy. But they have to put the water so high to cover it up, or else it looks like something out of pedophilia or something. Like, why would you put a naked boy standing to the naked man? That's just terrible. Now this place is pretty cool. It has maps from all around the world. Afghanistan, Kazakhstan, like kind of misspelled. This day is like the tourist sandwich. We started with some weird outside the box things like the gasification plant. In the middle we have the touristy stuff like Pike Place, and at the end we're gonna do some more outside the box off the grid stuff. Also, I'm a writer for an online company called Atlas Obscura, and check this out. Here's their book. This book is a New York Times bestseller too. No freaking way. One of the articles that I wrote, this one right here, made it into the book. That's awesome. What the heck? Look at these crazy umbrellas. Wow. This is Seattle's Chinatown, which is pretty cool. It's bigger than a lot of other Chinatowns.
That guy looks pretty happy. He has his fish and, you know.
finally, to conclude our one-day tour of Seattle, we're going to add some randomness into our day. This is the mystery soda machine.
All right, so you put in the money and it spits out a total mystery. Here we go. What soda will it be? All right, I'm gonna push the mystery button. So, making my selection. And the mystery is Fanta Strawberry. Not bad.
Nothing better than ending a long hot day with a refreshing drink. So, all that crazy stuff we did today was not enough. There's one more thing we have to do to get a taste of Seattle. It's time to troll.
Oh my God. Trolls do live under bridges, don't they?
Can I shake my fist? I'm just fine.
Can't get in the car. And if you you want to live by this troll,
just go to the Troll Eye Apartments.
Well, that's kind of it. Well, that's the best we could do for one day in the big city of Seattle. I will see you tomorrow where we are driving to Montana for some really freaking awesome stuff. Good night.